What's up, guys? I'm Chris Godber from GQ37. So why did I get a Manzo Axle Back exhaust? Let's find out. What's up, guys? So why did I buy a Manzo exhaust? Well, to be honest with you, it was just because I couldn't stand the way the car sounded stock. You gotta understand, coming into this car, I have had many cars before, two of which were 350Zs, and I modified the exhaust on both of those. One I did the Borla exhaust on, the other I did the NVIDIA Gemini exhaust. And I like the NVIDIA a lot better. The Borla just didn't do much for me. When I got my G35, I decided that, you know, I'm just going to leave the stock exhaust on here. The stock OEM exhaust that comes on those actually sounds really good, and it almost has an exotic semi-baritone kind of sound to it, and I was cool with it. It was there when you got on it, it mellowed out when you were cruising, and that's what an exhaust really should do. And it sounded good, so I decided just to leave that as it was. And I would have done the same with this if it sounded like that, but for whatever reason, the G37s and 370Zs, unless you get the Sport or Nismo exhaust or something like that, or the IPL exhaust, they just sound dull. When I got this, I thought I was driving a Camry the way it sounded. And I have a Sport model, it just didn't have the Sport exhaust on it for whatever reason. I didn't want to go with the whole big full exhaust system from the cat's back and all that stuff. You can squeeze out a couple more horsepower, but really it came down to price. The reason I wasn't trying to add horsepower was because I do plan on doing that. You know, you can never have enough horsepower, right? But I knew an exhaust really isn't going to do that much. I would rather do it all at one time. I plan on probably doing the Z1 performance package at some point, which, you know, the 400 horsepower thing will do intakes, headers, exhaust, manifold, tune, and all that at one time. That way I can really feel the difference in my butt dyno and on the real dyno at the same time. So that's what I want to do eventually. This was just a temporary fix, the axle back exhaust, and it fit the bill.
The Manzo exhaust can be had for less than $250 and looks eerily similar, if not the same, as the Rev9 Axleback exhaust, as well as the Top Speed Pro 1. Now, these are all budget-friendly options, and you really can't go wrong with any of them.
It's a real simple straight-through design. It's not quite a muffler delete. There are mufflers, but they're small mufflers, and it does deepen the sound a lot. You know, it's a lot more authoritative. It sounds good. It opens up that VQ sound a lot, which is what I wanted.
Well, there you have it, guys. I'm very happy and satisfied with the Manzo Axleback exhaust for what it is. Now, is it a Motordyne exhaust? No, but it also cost about 10% of that. If your main concern is just the sound, this is a quick and easy fix. Now, if I do other performance mods later on, I will upgrade then or do a custom piping and things like that to open it up more. But for what it is, I'm very happy with this. Is there a little bit of drone? Yes, there is, around the 2500 RPM range. If you're doing interstate driving, a lot of that you'll hear a little bit. It's mainly inconvenience talking on the phone more so than having conversations in the car. But I have a fix for that, and I'll show you that in the next video. It's without using a resonator. It's simple, it costs about $20, and I'll show you in the next video. Be sure to click subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. I said that like 5 times. I think it was just 3. Anyway, click subscribe, be sure to check it out, and I'll see you 4th time. Anyway, see ya. We'll